Hello students, welcome to the academic year 2020-21 at St. Joseph School. First of all, I would like to congratulate all of you for stepping into your high school. You all have opted for first language Sanskrit, second language English and third language as your Kannada. So today we shall begin with the poetry section of your second language English. The first poem that you'll be learning for this academic year is a very beautiful and small poem by E.A. Shaw. The name of the poem is Beauty. Before moving on to the poem, let's see about the poet of this poem. The poet of this poem is E.A. Shaw. Her original name was Louise Abita Chivivi. Louise Abita Chivivi was born on September 9, 1926 in southwestern part of America. She was a Puebloan writer, poet and educator. Puebloan are people who belong to Native America. They are basically Native Americans who live in southwestern part of America. E.A. Shaw is also called as Blue Corn. Her first book of personal reflections was published when she was only 13 years old. E.A. Shaw passed away on July 21st, 2014. So, she was basically a Native American writer, poet and educator. Before moving on to the poem, let us discuss about what is beauty. The word beauty is a very common word which we use in our everyday life. We use it in different contexts. What may appear beautiful to me may not appear beautiful to you. What may appear beautiful to you may not appear the same thing to your friends. In English, there's a popular saying, beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. When translated into Kannada, it means Saundaryavu Noduvavara Drishtiyallirutthade. When I tell you to tell a few things that are beautiful, some of the things that you may tell is beautiful forests, mountains, rivers, birds, flowers, a smile of a baby, a beautiful house, a peacock dancing, many things. There are many things which we can describe as beautiful. But are only these things beautiful? Let us see what the poet wants to say about beauty in this poem. We know that we are attracted by beauty. It means whenever there is anything that is beautiful, we are immediately captivated by its beauty. We are surrounded by beauty. Around us, God has given us so many beautiful things. God has given us this beauty for us to enjoy. We shall read about the poem now. I'll once read the poem and then explain to you paragraph wise. Beauty is seen in the sunlight, the trees, the birds, corn growing and people working or dancing for their harvest. Beauty is heard in the night, wind sighing, rain falling or a singer chanting anything in earnest. Beauty is in yourself, good deeds, happy thoughts that repeat themselves in your dreams, in your work, and even in your rest. We shall now see about the first stanza. Beauty is seen in the sunlight, the trees, the birds, corn growing and people working or dancing for the harvest. Here, you come across two new words. One is corn and another is harvest. Beauty is seen. Here the poet says that we can see beauty in the sunlight. We can see beauty in the trees. We can see beauty in the birds. We can see beauty in the corn that is growing in the field. And we can even see beauty in the people who are working, and the happiness when they are dancing at the time of their harvest. Harvest in Kannada, you call it as Sugi Samaya. In English, it means the time of the year when the crop is ready. We can see beauty in all these things. We can see beauty in the sunlight, the trees, the birds, the growing of the corn, the people working hard in the fields, or they dancing in enjoyment at the time of the harvest. We shall now analyze the first stanza. Beauty is in the eyes of the beholder. It is the attitude of a person. Beauty is everywhere. We can see it in the sunlight, the trees, the birds, the growing crops, people who dance to show their happiness when their crops are ready. A farmer works very hard across the year in his farm, and at the time when his crops are ready to be harvested, the enjoyment with which he dances or with he rejoices, there is even beauty in it. So the poet says that beauty is in the eyes of the beholder. The way a person looks at it, it lies in his own eyes. It is in our attitude. Beauty is seen everywhere. We have seen the first stanza. In this first stanza, I have given you a certain questions. 5 multiple choice questions. So that just to analyze whether you people have understood the poem or not. The first one is, where can we see beauty? Sunlight, trees, birds, or all of the above? The answer is all of the above, because the poet says that beauty can be seen in the sunlight, the trees, the birds, the corn, everywhere. How do people become beautiful? By decorating their houses, by wearing beautiful dresses, by working in the fields, by traveling to beautiful places. Here the poet has said that at the time of harvesting, the people sing with the joy, and in that joy we can see beauty. So by working in the fields, by working hard, people become beautiful. What makes people dance in the fields? Is it good harvest, beautiful scenes, beautiful birds, or fresh air? Of course it is good harvest. Good harvest is the product of all the hard work that a farmer does in the field. Who is the poet of this poem? The poet of this poem is E.A. Shaw. And what does the word harvest mean? It means crop. So this 5 multiple choice question just give us an analysis of the first stanza of the poem. Now we shall move to the second stanza. In the second stanza, the poet says, beauty is heard in the night, wind sighing, rain falling, or a singer chanting anything in earnest. Earnest, sincere, and honest conviction. In the first stanza, the poet says that beauty can be seen. But in the second stanza, he says, beauty can be felt also. It is a thing that can be felt. It can be heard. That is, one can listen to it. Like one can hear its sound when night falls. Because night is the time when there is peace and calmness everywhere. During daytime, due to our busy life schedules, we people don't give so much of importance for listening to all the beautiful things in nature. But when night falls, when everything is peaceful and calm, we tend to hear the sounds of nature. When night falls, when the wind blows and creates a sound, we can hear it. When rain falls on the earth, we can hear the clatter of the rainfall. We can see beauty in the song that a singer sings. When a singer sings with sincere and honest conviction, there is beauty in that song. So he says, beauty can not only be seen, but it can even be heard. Where all can we hear beauty? We can hear beauty when the wind blows, when the rain falls, when a singer sings. In all these things, beauty can be heard and felt. Students, we shall now listen to some of the sounds that are found in nature. We can find beauty in these sounds. I know most of you might have heard about these sounds. Yet, I want you people to learn them once. So, listen carefully to this sound. So, we heard about the sounds of the rain falling, the streams flowing, and the wind blowing. We shall now see if we have understood the second stanza by answering the following questions. When is beauty heard? In morning, in evening, in night, all the time. Beauty can actually be heard all the time, but night is the time when we can hear it very clearly because of peace and calmness. So beauty can be heard, according to the poem, clearly at night. How are sounds produced? By blowing winds and falling raindrops, by children's noise, by running vehicles on the road, by musical songs. Sounds are produced in nature when the wind blows and when raindrops fall on the earth. We can hear the clatter of the raindrops and the sound of the blowing wind. What effect do blowing of winds and falling of raindrops create? They create a very musical effect. When you hear the wind blowing and the raindrops falling, it creates a very musical effect on our ears. How can a singer create beauty? A singer can create beauty with his melodious voice, with his sweet melodious voice. When he sings with honest and earnest conviction, there can be beauty in his voice. What does the phrase in earnest mean? In this poem, the phrase in earnest means sincerely. When the poet sings sincerely, there is beauty in his melodious voice. We shall now see about the third stanza. Beauty is in yourself. Good deeds, happy thoughts that repeat themselves in your dreams, in your work, and even in your rest. The poet concludes in the third and in the last stanza in a very meaningful manner. In the first stanza, he had said, beauty can be seen. In the second stanza, he had said, beauty can be heard. But in the third stanza, he says that beauty is in yourself. It is in your good deeds, your happy thoughts, that you repeat yourself in your dreams, in your work, and even in your rest. Deeds here refers to our acts or actions. We shall now see the analysis of the third stanza. The poet says, beauty is not always external or visible. Every time, beauty may not be something that which we can only see with our eyes. There are so many beautiful things in this world which we cannot see with our eyes, which we can only feel. They are abstract in nature. Abstract things are those things which you cannot see, but which you can feel. For example, kindness, truthfulness, compassion, love, honesty, they are all virtues of human beings which have great beauty in them. But these beautiful things cannot be seen with our eyes. They can only be felt with our actions. One's views, good acts, our wishes, which we not only do in our everyday life, even which we imagine in our dreams also, there can be beauty in it. Beauty can be one way of work or even the style of taking rest. Thus, the concept or the very idea of beauty is very, very vast. It cannot be confined or restricted to one thing. Rather, beauty is there in everything. What we just need is eyes and a pure heart to see it. Only then we can find beauty in everything. For a mother, her child is always beautiful. Beauty is there everywhere. What we need is a pure heart and a pure soul to see it and experience it. We shall now have an understanding of the third stanza through a few questions. Where does real beauty lie? Real beauty does not lie in our beautiful personality. It is not in our singing. It is not in our status. It lies in our noble actions and happy thoughts. If you are kind to others, if you are compassionate to others, if you are good to others, beauty lies in our noble actions and happy thoughts. What does the poet want to say through the poem? Through this poem, the poet wants us to give us a message that beauty can be seen, it can be heard, and it can be even practiced in our life. Every day in our life, we can follow it by following good virtues of kindness, humility, compassion, love, understanding, mutual respect. In all these things, beauty is there. So if we follow all these things in our life can be very beautiful and many meaningful also. Which one of the following is not associated with real beauty? Good deeds, sweet ideas, quarrelsome nature, helping nature. Quarrelsome nature is something that is not associated with real beauty. What does the phrase repeat themselves mean here? Come again and again, reflected or shown, departed temporarily, none of the above. It is reflected or shown. When we reflect in ourselves all good virtues, if we show it in our life, only then life can be beautiful and meaningful. Inner beauty of a person is shown in his or her actions and ideas, in his or her dreams, in his or her work. It can be shown in all the above things. It can be shown in his or her actions and ideas. It can be shown in his or her dreams, in his work. So it is all of the above. Lastly, we shall once discuss about the summary in brief. The poet E.A. Shaw is trying to say in this poem that beauty is in everything. All the small things we do or the environment around us, everything has beauty in it. Everything has its own importance. All things are beautiful in their own unique way. Sunlight has its own beauty. Beauty can be seen in the growing corns. It can be seen in the people who are working and dancing for getting a good harvest. It can be seen in their hard work. Beauty is not only seen, but it can also be heard or felt. For instance, when night falls, wind blows slowly, the sound of the rainfall, or when a singer sings, all these things have beauty in it. They all give pleasure to the mind and make it feel happy. Beauty is not just outside, it is within. Beautiful is the self. Our good deeds, happy thoughts, please everyone, are all beautiful. Our dreams are also beautiful, as they give us reason to advance and work with zeal. Beauty is in our style of work, the way we take rest and sleep. In short, beauty is everywhere. It is in attitude, the way we look at things. Actually, everything is beautiful in its own unique manner. The need is to feel it. A pure heart, a pure soul can find beauty everywhere. If we have good qualities and good virtues like honesty, sincerity, humility, humbleness, all these things, if we imbibe in our life every day, we can make our lives beautiful. We can make our lives meaningful. We can even contribute to the good of our society. So beauty is not just external. Beauty lies even within ourselves also. We require a beautiful eye and a pure heart and a pure soul to see it. So this completes your poem. In your next poem, in your next video, we shall discuss about the question answers and the grammar part of this poem. If you have any doubts with regard to this poem, we shall discuss it when the school reopens.